What's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. Just want to do a quick Happy New Year. 2019 is here. I know I'm a little late to the game. It's been crazy busy over here in terms of just a lot going on. My kids are out of school, getting work done on the house. Went on vacation for my wife's birthday. Busted my foot up. It's been rough the first 20 days, but it's all been good because life is great and I'm doing wonderfully and I'm excited about the year. I got up yesterday and went out to Ventura, which is a beach town out here in Southern California. Went to a dog show and met a lot of great people. Actually met a young lady named Ashley. Let me do some housekeeping first. First and foremost, I do have a YouTube channel along with an Instagram, a Facebook, and a Twitter account. Those are all Dogumentary TV. If you guys have a second, please go and sign up. Secondly, I want to send a big shout out to my homeboy, James Cooper, BullySupplies.com. If you guys wear bully gear, t-shirts, hats, anything in dealing with actually all dog breeds now. He done stepped his game up and he's doing all dog breeds. Check out BullySupplies.com. It's a great place to get you some amazing merchandise. Represent your breed, represent your dog, represent the community. But like I said, yesterday I went to this dog show. It was in Ventura. I met a young lady. Her name is Ashley. Hopefully I'll be connecting with Ashley sometime this week. She has two dogs, Caucasian Ovcharkas. I never would have imagined, never would have thought that I would have stumbled upon a person who was actually owning these dogs in a pet home. Never thought that they would actually be so close to me as to give me the opportunity to go do a quick little video. So I'm hoping to get that done real soon. Also, I met some people who have rough and smooth collies. So that's a video that's gonna be popping off real soon. Tomorrow, I'm gonna be connecting with Gerald Antoine. You guys know him, he's a Doberman dude. We're gonna do an update video on his dog. Also, I'm going to do an update video on Brutale, the Cane Corso. So there's a lot going on right now. I know I got off to a very slow start this year. Like I said, there was a lot going on in my life. So I had to kind of... And then the other thing was I was really ready to go last week. But then the other thing was California, it rained all last week. Which, if you're in Southern California, you understand that we cannot complain about the weather. We cannot complain about rain. We, for the most part, live in a desert, and with all these global issues going on, we don't get as much rain as we need to. So that rain that we got, it was well worth it. It has slowed me down a bit, but that's all good. I'll take the rain any and every day when I'm in Southern California. Other than that, I hope everybody's New Year is going great. Hope you guys get off to a good start. And I'm going to start just taking a... Just start reading some questions. So Bobby Anderson said, what about the Canis Panther? I do know a little bit about it. There are not a lot of people out there with it, not a lot of breeders. I did a video already. There's a woman up in Central California. She crosses, I believe, Dog de Bordeaux and Dobermans, and that's how she creates her Canis Panthers. There's several different variations or formulas for making that breed, but I personally I don't know a whole lot about it. Like I said, it's just not something I know a lot about. But they're beautiful dogs, and hopefully I'll come across somebody who has a real serious working program with the breed, and I'll do that. Oh, before I go too much further, I want to say happy birthday to the biggest homeboy, Martin Luther King Jr. We appreciate you. I appreciate you. I grew up in the shadow of your existence. Very soon after you were taken from us, I was born, and I know that you did a lot of work and put forth a lot of good energy, good theories, good concepts that we're still trying to figure out today. We're not perfect, we're not there yet, but I do want to thank Martin Luther King Jr. and his family for all the wonderful things they've done for people, for the United States, and especially for, people like myself, black people living in America. People all over the world. The man did his thing. So let's all respect Martin Luther King, and let's celebrate him on his day. All right, so let's see what else we got here. We got, let's get them likes up. I love likes. You guys hit me with some questions now. I'm looking at the comments again. I'm sorry. Yeah, much respect to Martin Luther King. Like I said, I literally, you know, before Barack Obama, he was the black president. Bernice Mountain Dog, I'll work on that. Oh, so just so you guys know, also, 2019, I'm trying to go super hard. I'm looking to go, Rottweiler's my favorite dog, Joe. I'm looking to go super hard, followed closely by a Borbo kind of course. I love a lot of dogs, but Rottweiler, I'm just going to just stop there. I'm going to go real super hard. I'm trying to get as many dog breed, like all about videos done this year for this channel. So, and I'm going to do all dog breeds. I know if you guys know me, you know I like big dogs, I like Mastiff, I like Bull breeds, and then I like Terrier breeds. But it's Dogumentary TV, so that means that, you know, I need to be focused on all breeds, all right? So I'm going to do that. And you'll get that. In addition, I spent some money this year and I bought a new camera. So hopefully I'll be able to do a little bit more 4K content. I don't know if that makes a difference to you guys, but we'll see. I'm going to work on a dachshund video. The cool thing about it is that I've actually been getting a lot of good energy and reception at the dog shows now. So I should be able to get, I mean, most every breed. Because the channel's been relatively successful and the presentation has been very professional. Excuse me. And because you guys have been so, for the most part, the audience has been, you know, very responsive. That gives me a lot of cachet when I introduce myself. A lot of people now actually know who I am, and they're willing to open up their home and their yard to me and allow me to come and film. So hopefully, like I said, this year my plan is to get a lot of work done. I did put a call out for the Black Mouth Cur. I got a guy up in Northern California. And hopefully I can get make some time to go film with him. I'm actually going to call him sometime this week. I called him last week. And he said he'd get back to him. He's going to take a look at my stuff. So we'll see how that goes. If you're anywhere in the country and you want to find dog shows, if you want to go to an AKC show, you just go to the AKC website. They will lead you in the direction. They have a schedule for all their shows. It's just like AKC events. I would do that. Will there be a 2 to American Lion? There will be a part 2 to American Lion Hound. I also have a Spanish Bulldog video coming up real soon as well, and I'll try to get all that done this week. Actually, I just been kind of caught up in life. In terms of what dogs I have, I just have a pit bull. He's in the house. He's a little mixed dog. I don't know. I wouldn't call him pure pit bull. I would call him a pit bull because that's pretty much what he is. But you know, in the world of internet. And how strict people are, like, yo, like, is he 100% pit bull? I don't know, but for the most part, he has all the callings of a pit bull: temperament, you know, his look, size, weight, all that's pretty much the same thing. He has, his ears are funny, and his body's a little different, but amazing dog, great dog. He's 11 years old now, literally my best friend. I'll tell you guys a quick story. I wish I could pull back and show you guys how big I am. I'm a big dude. But this big dude was crying last week. My dog had got out the yard. I basically have a gardener that comes in here. He cleans my backyard up and mows my lawn and all that stuff. He shut my gate, but he didn't latch my gate. So if you walk by out the house when I did in the morning, the gate looked like it was closed, but it wasn't. So I guess at some point in the day, the wind blew, the gate opened, and my dog was out. And I literally spent 2 hours driving around my neighborhood looking for him. I really couldn't believe that, I was really, just can't even tell you how upset I was with my garden. It's a good thing I didn't see him at that time, because I had already told him on several occasions, make sure you close my gate. I have a dog. I have a dog, close my gate. So the dog got out or whatever. But the cool thing is, he is microchipped. So when they found him, literally, they brought him in, they found him, and then within 10 minutes, I went down and I got him, and I was happy to have him back. But yeah, so that's the dog I have. But I don't know, I just wanted to tell you that story. I don't know, it's not a big deal. Love your dogs, cherish your dogs, honor your dog's existence, because when you lose them, it's gonna hurt. That's, I don't even care. I don't care how you lose them. It's going to hurt. And I had a little taste of that. So, you know, I just, a little bit more respect, a little bit more appreciation for my dog and what he means to me in my life. All right. Hey, AKC has now recognized Deborable. I mean, listen, we can hate on the AKC all we want, but the reality of it is like, there's no need. Hold on. I'm sorry. The AKC, you can hate on them all we want. The reality of it is, and I don't disagree that they kind of mess up dog breeds. I mean, all dog shows, but it's not just the AKC. It's really a kennel club kind of institutional thing. They get fixated on certain traits, looks, just things that aren't necessarily important to a dog's health and well-being. And we got to fix that. So we don't necessarily want to get rid of the kennel clubs, because a lot of the kennel clubs are doing great work with a lot of different breeds, and even are preserving some breeds that most people no longer even want to deal with. So instead of, you know, hating on the AKC, I would just figure out, like, how would you get into those organizations or petition those organizations for them to behave better and to have better practices when it comes to dog breeding and the care and taking for dogs. I'm not going to be on here long. I told myself 15 minutes because I got a kid's birthday party to go to. Yeah, I have a friend of mine, her daughter just turned probably, I guess she turned 6 today. So I got to run to that birthday party. But I wanted to jump on here to let you guys know that there's stuff coming. I have heard of the Alant dog. I haven't, obviously it's not a dog that's in the States for the most part. I would have to go digging to find that dog and try to do my best to get them for you. I'm gonna read a couple of more questions before I go. I can't wait to own a Borble. Borbles are great dogs. I mean, I would own a Borble. There's a lot of dogs I would own. Have you heard of a Carolina? I have heard of a Carolina dog and American Dingo. There's a lady up here, I think it's in Northern California, that has them. I'll try to connect with her again and see if I can do it. What do you think about the English Staffy? It's a great dog. I got a couple of English Staffy videos on my channel. If you haven't had a chance to take a look at them, you should. There's a woman out here. Her name's Lorraine. I don't know Lorraine Wilson, I think is her last name. She breeds, I think it's called Staffy Bulls or Incredibles. I forget what her kennel's called. But she has great Staffordshire Bull Terriers. Australian Bulldog, I would love to get to Australia. Australia is one of the places I'm most fascinated with. So if I do have the opportunity to get over there, I will definitely get over there and do do something on that. You know, I remember I can actually bring these comments back. The Bayer Shepherd, they are very similar to the Kangaloo, a little bigger, a little thicker. But as a guy in Texas, there's a lot of work to get done, right? I'm just one person. I use my resources wisely and efficiently. As you can see, I don't have a huge estate. That's my house right there. It's a very little, very modest house. You know what I'm saying? So I don't have tons of money to travel all over the world. But, you know, I got plans and all that stuff. I'm going to pull some more comments down. Getting a Patterdale, that's dope. Patterdales are great dogs. Kangaloo is a great dog. I mean, most dogs are great. That's the reality of just dogs. I mean, that's the beauty of dogs. And most of them are great. What you do is you find the right dog for yourself. You get a dog the right life, the proper environment, proper exercise, good food. And you're going to, like I said, you're going to have a dog for life that you can cherish. He's going to cherish you. Dogs are amazing. That's why, you know, I dedicated my professional career right now is dedicated to documentary TV, because I was able to combine two of my biggest passions, filmmaking and dogs. So, you know, that's what's up with that. Let me go through this thing. All right, we're about to hit 15 minutes. All right, so I think I'm gonna work today on a little video on like collies and rough collies. I shot some footage at the show this weekend. I'm going to try to get that Lion Hound Part 2 video up this week. I'm going to shoot the Doberman tomorrow. I'm going to work on trying to shoot or film the the Caucasian Ocharkas. I'm going to try to work on setting. I just got a lot of work to do. Videos are coming. I appreciate you guys. This is going to be quick, and then I'll do more of these as well. I just got back my little gimbal to hold my phone still, so I look kind of a little bit more professional, not like really I'm still holding it, but I'm not like holding it. I can actually hold it out here and it stays pretty steady. What up, McG? I'm doing great. Thank you. I appreciate it. I hope you guys are doing great. You know, I want you guys also to realize this is a new year, so this is a new opportunity to refresh yourself, refresh your mind, your body, and your spirit. You know, take good care of yourselves first, and then, you know, you love the ones around you as well. You try to, you know, you become a healthy, efficient, or effective distributor of love, and you give it to the people closest to you, the animals closest to you. But you yourself got to be in a good position, so you got to be healthy and happy yourself. I did watch the football games yesterday. We could talk about that, DJ Academics hairline. Yeah, we could talk about that. I live in LA right now, so I was cool with the Rams winning. I'm not a big Rams fan, but I live in LA now, so and they just got back here, so I will accept them as a team that I should cheer for, and I do cheer for them. But I always have been like a kind of a New Orleans fan as well. I like New Orleans. I like the city. I like the culture in New Orleans. So in that game, it was kind of a push for me. Whoever won, I would have been cool with, but I was probably leaning a little bit more towards LA because I live in LA. In regards to the Chiefs and the Patriots, I was going for the Chiefs. I can't even lie to you guys. I'm not a big fan of the Patriots. Just to say that, I'm not a big fan. Respect Tom Brady. Respect Bill Belichick. Yeah, I respect the Patriots. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like football is like a movie. And every good, in order for a movie to be real good, you got to have a good villain, right? You got to have a Mr. T. You got to have a Darth Vader. You got to have somebody that you can hate. And for me, it's the Patriots and it's the Cowboys. I hate them both. I respect the Patriots, though. you caught what I just said there. I respect the Patriots, though. All right, let me see what's up. So I'm looking to get that Roddy real soon. And actually, my wife is texting me. That's why I keep hitting the screen. And I'm over. So, all right, guys, I'm gonna stop right now. I just want to thank you guys. If you guys want, leave me in the comments what you think we should talk about next. Like, what we can have a live stream later this week. I'm just maybe send me a topic or something that you guys want to talk about. I'm a big fan of Cali Catchers. I send him a text message once a week. Not once a week, like once a month, trying to get him to do something on my channel. But I don't know why he won't do it. Somebody just sent something. Let me see what that is. Malik M, thank you, brother, for the donation or the what do they call that again? The super chat. I appreciate the donation, bro. I'll make sure I put it to some good use. We'll do some more doxing videos. I love you guys as well. I appreciate the love. You know, love is a good thing. It's a great currency. You know, money's cool. But, you know, love, a lot of times you can get a lot done in the world by just telling somebody that you love and appreciate them. Because when I first started this channel, I wasn't making any money on this channel. I was actually just doing it because I loved and appreciated it. And people loved it as well. And this is the last thing I'm going to say. Band Dogs. 2019, I will definitely do a Band Dog video. I will travel and do a Band Dog. I'm going to get the best possible Band Dog video for you guys. All right, so I'm gonna figure that out. I've been slacking, I've been slew footing with it. I'm gonna make that happen. All right, guys. What was your question, Kim? I'm sorry, I didn't see it. This is gonna be the last one. You guys, you know, I hate leaving y'all because y'all cool people. I love the energy. Like I said, I love the energy. Kim, ask your question again though for me because I didn't see it. So once Kim asks her question, I'm gonna go. And Dogumentary TV is the Instagram. MW, thank you, brother. American Centennial. Yeah, I'm gonna talk to them. That's in Mississippi. So like I said, I'm gonna travel. If I gotta go there, I'm gonna travel and do that. Kim, I never saw your question. You said you wanted to ask a question. Shucks. All right, well, Kim's not re-asking a question. So what I'm going to do is, Kim, if you leave your question in the comment section, I'll be sure to look for it today. I'll answer it. Or actually, I'll go back. If you ask the question, I'll go back and answer it. I'll answer your question. But I'm going to get up out of here. I'll see if Diane Jessup wants to do something again, if she has some more information she wants to share. She was definitely a great interview, and I definitely appreciate her. All right. Thanks, guys. I appreciate you. 2019, we're going to do it big. We're going to get through a lot of all about. We're going to get through a lot of breeds this year. That's my goal. All right. Thanks again. Peace. I don't know how to stop it. we stop this thing. All right, that's going to be it, guys. Peace.